Welcome to the Spy Collection. I'm Anastasios and in this episode we'll cover a topic that is one of the biggest secrets of military intelligence agencies. In the Western world, it is typically referred to as TECHINT or technical intelligence, and it's how to derive intelligence from weapons and equipment used by foreign actors. TECHINT is typically split into a three-phase process, and to make it more practical, we'll use some rare artifacts that we have in the Spy Collection from the war between Russia and Ukraine. Specifically, those are components from the Russian 9K-7 Iskander, NATO-designated as SS-26 Stone, mobile short-range ballistic missile system that you see in this video here. The first phase of TECHINT is the collection. Here we have some sockets and a PCB from an Iskander missile to demonstrate this step. Apparently, all military spy agencies will go at great lengths to ensure they obtain them in as complete and intact state as possible. However, even small fragments like that can be invaluable when producing intelligence on previously unknown weapon systems. After the collection, we go to the second phase, the exploitation and analysis. And here is where experts in the different material will analyze them and document them in detail. For instance, this one here is from a lightweight aluminium body with a coating, while this one is from a heavier alloy. They'll record the type of connectors that are being used, the number of pins, how the grounding is implemented, the size of the bolts and threads and sockets, of course the part numbers, and the various techniques used, like this locking wire. Now for electronic components, like this PCB here, they would typically follow a process known as hardware reverse engineering. This process is typically executed in the following steps for a simple PCB like this one. First, observe and document all of the parts of the board. Hence, for instance, these two 11PA1A chips. Those are high-speed 12-bit digital-to-analog converters for analog I/O blocks designed for military applications. Next, we have four 1533IR33, which are military-grade transistors with Schottky diodes. After writing down all the components in a table, the reverse engineer will add some additional context for each one, meaning how many pins each component has or each manufacturer. For instance, this symbol here tells us that this comes from the Latvian military semiconductors company Alpha, which was once part of the Soviet Union's military industrial complex. Or this symbol here. This is from the Russian JSC Proton company that specializes in low-power optoelectronics and other electronic components, including military-grade ones. And this symbol here is from the Belarusian semiconductor manufacturer Integral. After documenting all of those parts and their information, the reverse engineer would use a PCB design software to link all of them so that they can have a digital copy of this board. Lastly, they'll add some additional information, such as what materials were used for this PCB. For instance, here you can clearly see that there was also a protective clear coating. so they'll have to also identify that and document it. And we also have some identification codes. If we search for this, we'll see that it's a Russian classification code for radio electronic control, communication, navigation, and computer technology. After having done this, we move to the last phase of TECHINT, the intelligence production. Here, an expert in such missile systems will take all of that information and produce a finished intelligence product. For example, they might have a 3D model where they'll match the components we just described and gradually have a complete reconstruction of the entire weapon system. They might simply publish a quick write-up on the manufacturers that this weapon relies on and the materials used so that policy makers can employ sanctions against them or plan covert operations to sabotage them. They could even look for vulnerabilities, such as flaws in the design or materials used, which could be attacked to reduce the effectiveness of the weapon. And lastly, also extract good practices and methodologies and disseminate them to their own military-industrial complex to improve their equivalent weapons. And with that, we conclude the TECHINT cycle. And in case you wonder, here are some photographs showing where those pieces came from. It was from the tail of a Russian Iskander missile that hit outside Kyiv in 2022. If you'd like us to do some more in-depth TECHINT videos with artifacts recovered from the war in Ukraine, please let us know in the comments below. In the meantime, we hope that this gave you a better understanding of TECHINT and showed you how nothing is as it seems.